Okay, Ginger's all combed out. This is a Shihtzu, and she'll be in a hand scissor with a little bit longer legs. So she's got a really long body. And I hate it when people do videos, and that's how they sit and talk. They talk and talk and talk before the action happens. So I'm just gonna talk as I'm doing the action, and I might explain what I'm doing, but I'm definitely gonna show you by video. So I've gotten the pads all scooped up. Okay, and all the privates in eyes. And I'm ready to start with my clip-on since she's completely combed out. No snarls, because if you try to do this when there's a snarl, it'll leave a big gouge and like a chop mark and it won't look good. And you'll try to be fixing it up for the rest of the groom. So this little bit of time you spend, and I'll make sure I get the finer part of the comb to go through it. No resistance. All right, very methodical. I like to start at the back of the head and go with the grain. This clip-on comb is just leaves about 3/4 of an inch left. It's going to seem like you're going to get more off in certain areas because of the different coat textures. She's actually a mix of some sort, so she has a little bit of an undercoat. And with hair that I call sticky, doesn't want to comb out real well. And then while I'm getting on the hip, I make sure I'm doing the full fledge to the skin, combing out with the clip comb. And then I'm gonna start at the hip and I want straight legs. So when I look at her this way, it's just straight up and down, no hip movement or inward, outward. So I'll take the hip and just come straight down like there's an imaginary line, like I can't go any deeper. Onto the comb. Then with the front, make sure she stands up straight, and then I'm going to come under and go in so it looks like her legs are under her. And it helps shorten the length of her body as far as aesthetically looking wise. It makes them appear more correct. Okay, so, and then there's an imaginary line, come straight down off the shoulder. Curly thing here going on. Sometimes you can get it to lie flat with the dryer, but she's just impossible. She starts curling up like while I'm grooming her. Seems like good girl. And I'm going with the comb just in case I missed a snarl. And I want that coat to lay down straight so I can make sure I'm clipping with the grain. And you don't want to have any clipper marks. So it's to look as natural as possible. So, and I don't want these hairs sticking down when she's walking or moving. So I do go against the grain on the belly with this clip cone or whatever blade I would be using. Sticky out it is, huh? Start scissoring. So I said, I did the pads already, so I'm just gonna comb all this down and give her a little bit of a bevel. Tighten right up. So I'm not gonna cut into like this, because that's gonna make her have pointy toes. We wanna make her look like she has kind of bigger feet. Here we go. I'm holding her up so her legs are nice and held up in a natural way. Okay. And this is a curve, and I'm just gonna go around them. I'm sure you know what to do. So I did most of the work with this whole leg just skimming down, so it makes it less time consuming. Nice little angle here. And if you move your scissors in a way that is similar to a clipping blade that's cutting the fast motion, and get even, even do that with your scissors. So, you know, like it's a clipper, but at certain times you'll cut and there won't be any hair, but just a dusting, which just gives it that nice polished look that you've spent all day scissoring. Okay, just flick it up a little bit here now. Yes. Once I'm done with her, I'll take the camera and go around her whole body in a close-up range. So it looks like she's just standing on her little tippy toes. Okay. I'm gonna go over this way a little bit. There we are. And then you'll work up to the front. Okay, now with this clip-on stuff, with this type of hair, just flip it up a little bit and do the same thing with your scissors. Very fast dusting. Watch. Just to get them sticky outies and give it that polished look. Yeah, it's just stiff together already. It's just no matter what kind of conditioner you use, with this air, just it's inevitable. Yeah, you want the no hair to come out of the shoulders, so that needs to go. See? It needs to come right down off the shoulder. And she's got a, many Shihtzu mixes do, a bow out in her front legs. And so you have to try to hide it through the hair. Make it look like she has straight legs. We'll give her a little feet, a little angulation under here. Okay. Okay, this sucks, but it's gonna look better when I show you the close up. Just go get it. Sometimes the dogs be running on the floor and I'll see something on their way out. And stop, let me get that. So she's got this, so a lot of Shihtzu mixes as well too. The rear is higher than the front. So they got this slope. So try to fix that. Thank you. type of hair, I don't know if you've noticed, I'm barely touching it with my fingers because the oils in my hands are gonna make it separate and curl up and looks messy. So I try not to touch it like my hand too much because it's gonna affect how it lays and all that good stuff. It drives me nuts when the owners come to get their dog and they're like, oh, hi, Fluffy, you just ruined my haircut. See, her physical toe actually faces out that way. We've been trying to make that look straight up and down. There we go. Tip her up. I'll try to go a little bit tighter here under the chin. Just create some length on the neck. Again, shorten up that body a little bit. See what her body looks like in her face, obviously. That's for the next video. I hope this turns out. I don't know. Shoot.